casino in Crete, they have their own ravioli. They stuff with an artichoke and olive blend, served on a pesto that could fill you like a soup if you were so inclined. No, the fine Italians of Crete know a ravioli. My compliments to the chef. And the lamb chops. Such a flavor spectrum. Truly the pomegranate molasses with a fair cherry on top of a fruit of a different flavor. Mmm. Ladies and gentlemen, by way of introduction, this is a film about ambition and luck. And well, of course, growing up, every film is about that in some way. In this, I will be your guide. You may not know me, but I know you. Not well, of course, but maybe. I will give you three things. First is my name, Stephen Howie. Second is my promise. Everything you hear me say in the next 7 minutes is true. And third, story.
Connor, stop. Fuck. I got it. Like-
Connor Daniels? Who is Connor Daniels?
Meet me.
Speed. That question has not been answered yet with any certainty. But let's try. Small film appearances.
Fire all the nukes we have. Guaranteed duck pee.
Boo!
All we know so far is that Connor Daniels had an idea.
Is on? I'm gonna change the focus. Alright. Here's the idea. I just came out of the shower, but I have an idea. I need to record this right now. The Toys R Us sign is still up there in Bellevue, the one in Bellevue. Store's closed, chapter 13. I get the sign, put it above my house, I got the Toys R Us sign. It's foolproof.
Foolproof.
It is foolproof. Remember, future Connor. Foolproof. Okay, that's cool.
Now we know who he is, and we think we know where he's going. Let's go back.
I don't wanna grow up, find a Toys R Us kid. They got a million toys and Toys R Us that I can play with. I don't wanna grow up, I'm a Toys R Us kid. They got the best for so much less, you really flip your lid.
Toys R Us? How quaint.
But that's not how Toys R Us started, no. No, it started in just below the booming New Jersey skyline, not in a skyscraper or a corporate office either. No, you could say Toys R Us made landfall around the same time the USS Nevada lumbered into port, returning the brave American souls of that generation stateside in 1945, to a crowd eagerly waiting their arrival. On that boat was a cartographer by the name of Charles Lazarus. As he returned home with his unit back to his father's bike shop, he knew something. Everyone he talked to said they were going to go home, get married, and have children, and he was going to be the man to fill their toy chests with joy. So he used the upstairs floor of his father's bike shop to sell toys and baby clothes, and boy was it an idea.
How to get out of parking lot. There it is, yes. Can see the Toys R Us. And, oh, just trying to park. Alright, buddy. I am Connor Daniels. I am, will be, always be, forever, in eternity, I'm barking. A Toys R Us kid. Don't want to grow up. Gonna be a Toys R Us kid. We're here.
There it is. Wow. It's Babies R Us. Don't want that sign. No thanks.
First discovery. There are actually two signs. There's one up here, and there's actually the one in the back.
It is, alright. Good.
But could he get either? That was the question.
You know, though, I'm looking at the letters so close up. Those would not fit in my room. I'm gonna get one. Maybe in my garage, something like that. It's not gonna stop me.
Something weird about this door.
The place looks pretty well fortified, wouldn't you say?
Till next time, Toys R Us sign.
You will be mine.
Alright, I'll be right back. Just gonna do a little investigating over there. Nobody touched the camera.
Both are bolted in with electric wiring to each part of them, making it quite hard to in any way sneakily undo that without, I don't know, mass power outage. All right, good news, bad news. Signs are still there. Bad news, signs are not in my house.
Searching here, let's see. Ryan Calizid. Calizid. Mount Lake Partners.
Through some investigated Googling, I was able to find the man who seemed to be the real estate agent for this building. Got his phone number and gave him a call.
Have you reached Ryan Cablis with Mount Lake Partners? Please leave a message and I'll return your call as soon as possible. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hi Ryan, this is Connor Daniels.
A rather boilerplate message for such an important call. No matter. We find Connor in a state of optimistic excitement over his possible future prize. But never so fast that the best laid plans of mice and men fall just beyond reach.
I think that went well. To the research phase. So, direct approach. Are signs free after the building? It goes away. Can I take the Toys R Us sign?
So we're assuming that Toys R Us is out of bankruptcy, out of Chapter 13. So out of that process, normally someone would have gotten the rights to the brand, the Toys R Us brand, which would include the rights to their logo, which that sign is of their, you know, is their logo. So I would find out who has that. And you could probably do that by researching online, find out who it is.
All right.
An interesting approach. Not one Connor would take, though.
How legal would you say it would be to just kind of, you know, go and take it? Okay, thanks, John. Got my safety goggles, got my official vest for looking more official. Along with that, got my official beer. Not really, it's a liquid death, it's just water, but it is empty. And this is the thing I am drinking. I got my 16-foot pole, I shoved it into my car. It is now a 14-foot pole. That was very sharp to drive next to. Alright, I think we're ready. Let's go in for the kill.
But the good fortune couldn't last forever.
You liked that place a lot. We spent a lot of time there. It's a big place. We'd go, and you'd want to run around to all of the different aisles. And, you know, when you're a kid, I couldn't see your head above the aisle, so it was sort of easy for you to get lost. So I would choose a place in the store, and I'd say, this is where we'd meet. I'd say, okay, and off you'd run. And sometimes you'd come back to that place, but sometimes I'd need to go looking for you because there would be something fascinating that you were looking at. But that was all right. We had fun.
Any cool adventures, special memories of Toys R Us?
I don't remember anything particularly special about adventures at Toys R Us. No. You liked a lot of different toy stores, and we spent time in a lot of different ones. So, no, I don't remember anything special.
Okay, thanks.
Category killers such as Walmart, Target, and Amazon honed in on Toys R Us's profits, selling toys as lost leaders.
All right, so we're here at the location, second location. It says it's back here, but that looks creepy as hell. So, here we go, Toys R Us. Hello? Toys R Us? No? No? Ooh. Alright, we're out. We made it. Looks like Toys R Us did not. That, my friend, that's a sign. Empty sign. Toys R Us was here. Alright, so if we look
around. In an effort to branch out and check out different locations, I went to one in Tukwila to see if I could find another Toys R Us sign.
That way. Let's go.
And that's when the camera battery died.
This is our Toys R Us location right here. Actually, home store, because you got that square type building, big kind of sign location. Looks very new, perhaps 2017 new. So unless we want the Ashley Home Store sign, which, you know, it's all right, but it's no Toys R Us, this is a bust. It's a Five Guys over there, but, you know.
Sometimes it's hard to live with failure.
only way to stay afloat was a corporate buyout from KKR. Vornado. And Bain Capital. For $6.6 billion, loading the company with $5 billion in debt.
My phone has alerted me. I have a new voicemail, so very exciting. Let's see. Hopefully, it's our boy, it's our man.
One new voice message. New message.
Hey, Connor, it's Dad. I was hoping you could help me out with getting that gardening done that you promised to do. So let me know when it's done. Talk to you soon. Ciao, Dad.
To replay this message, press 1. To delete, press that message marked for deletion. There are no more messages.
Charles Lazarus stepped down as CEO in 1994, leading to a revolving door of 7 CEOs, the last being Dave Brandon, a former board member of Domino's Pizza in 2015. Still owing mountains of cash and debt to the buyout companies, Brandon filed Chapter 13 bankruptcy unsuccessfully and was forced to liquidate.
I knew then what I know now. A larger ladder wouldn't have helped. I couldn't have taken that sign. It was the only thing left.
Don't think you'll grow up. No, not just yet. But that's okay. It is. This story isn't over. True, false. Either way, we go on telling it. Because how can you not?
Isn't that right, Connor?
And with that, story told, book complete, I wish you all, truly this time, a good evening.
Lazarus died March 22nd, 2018. It was reported he had no knowledge of the liquidation.
So magically, your aisles were split into the pink and blue. Have I grown? Where have you gone? Do you want some batteries? Just wandering. Chapter 13, and liquidation. Looks like Jeffrey's on permanent vacation, whistling another tired song. Clearance tags and constant child fuss, heart locked in a Toys R Us. It beats a lonely rhythm all night long. it beats a lonely rhythm all night long. It beats a lonely rhythm all night long.
Yay! Let's see how that sounded. That was cool.